Hello, welcome to KAJOS Consultant. I'm your host, Joshua. And today I'll be taking you through data coding and data entry using SPSS. So once you open your SPSS software, the SPSS interface will appear the way it is right here. So in the SPSS interface, down here, you have the data view and you have the variable view. So we'll start by coding the side of the variable view. So in the variable view, we can have variables which will the sum of the equation which you already have in your SPSS in your equation here. And here, let's say for example, you have your the biodata which we'll now want to need to code. So for example, our number one personal information can be gender. So you can enter the name, can type gender. And also remember that under the name column, it doesn't allow any spacing. So you have to do everything without having any spacing. That is in case you have more than two words to enter. So gender, then our type. Yeah, you can have it as numeric because you are going to do the coding. So in the coding section, once you have the values column, I'm going to tell you what to do. So width simply tells when you will be doing your data entry, how many words will you enter? So if you know your words will be two, you can have your width as two. If it will be one, you can have your values as one. And also note that the number of decimals cannot be more than the width. So if you have then decimal here, you can have a decimal a zero. So meaning for the general, you're not going to have any number with the decimal value with any decimal. Then under label, you can choose to leave it blank or you can just still type the gender. But here in this section column of label, you can allow spacing. It can now allow spacing. Then values, you can here the car come here and do the coding. You can have number one value. Then can label this as a male. Then we click here, then icon add. It will add to the dialog box as it appear here. Then you can have a number two. Number two, we can have as a female. Then we add, it appears there. Then you click OK, it will add. Once you click the OK, the values will add as it is here. Then we have no missing value at this point. Then columns, you can leave it as 8 or you can set any number of columns that we need, but doesn't have nearly great effect on the type of data that will be generated here. Then alignment. Here you can align to the right, just the same way where if you have ever used the Word document or Excel, you've always come across the alignment where you can align to the center, to the right, or to the left. So for this case, you can just align our values to the right. Then the measure. So this can be nominal. We can be scale. Scale and nominal are more or less the same. Those can be nominal because we have coded our values as male number one and two also, which means for any questionnaire which is marked, any respondent which will mark him, will mark his or her gender as male, will be coding one. Then the role we are doing here, we are going to do data input. So this one, the under role, it remains input the way it is. So our number two, we can have education level, education. Level. So somewhere can also be in our decimal places. You have it as zero. So here, remember I told you under name, you don't allow any space. That's why education and level have written them as one word. Then under label, and label that you can now have it in the correct way, education, then level, now with a space. So values, number one, you can have those who have pursue their education up to primary level. Then number two, you can have those who have pursued the education up to secondary. So you tap here secondary and a label, then you click add. Then number three, we can have tertiary level. You add, it will appear all the values and the labels will appear in the dialog box as indicated here on the SPSS interface. Then you click OK. Once you are free, you are through with adding all the values. Then click OK, it will add automatically. Then measure here, you can come and change it to nominal. Then you are doing the role of data input. Then you can also have marital status. And so now number three variable, counts numeric. Then yeah, we have it as number of days to be zero. Then under the label, you have it as marital status. So marital, you can have a single, it's number one single, click add. Then number two can have married. Then number three can have divorced. Number four, you can have widowed. Yeah, click OK. Once you are done with importing all the values and the label, click OK to add it there. Then you can still have nominal because you have coded our values. However, in case of just typing the word married or single, will be required to indicate either one or two. Then the role we are doing here is data input. So having demonstrated this, you can now come and click on the data view side. So in your questionnaire, we'll find the data view, we'll find all the variables which you had generated. They are all there, arranged in that manner. We have the gender, you have the education level, and you have the marital status. So gender, we can have those who marked as maybe male, can indicate as one. If the person's education level or secondary, you can mark two. Marital status, if the person is married, you can also mark two, because that is what we have there. You can also come here and mark, maybe this person was now married, education level number three, maybe tertiary, marital status, person, let's say is single. So you can have that data that way. So also if you want to check if your entries are correct, you can always come here and check on the value labels. Here we have the capital A at the top and the one at the bottom. This one can help you to alternate between doing a normal data, just keying in the values or just clicking here and having these values, having the right values which we entered when we are doing the coding. So in this case, we'll find that they are all value. For example, if you click here on the gender, we'll find a drop down arrow, which will now indicate direct whether to click on male, whether to mark whether the person is female or male. Same if you come to education level, you can still do the same. Drop down menu, primary, secondary, tertiary, you choose the one you want. Yeah, so this is all about just a sample example of how to do data coding and data entry. Thank you very much for watching.